think about the idea of the live thing where you actually come out and you tape the show, you know, and you get the bands, even if you don't play the sound on some of them, but you know, they're only... I mean, what... Yeah. But on the good ones, or all of them,
oh, yeah.
I mean, what do you... I mean, are you into the idea of actually coming out to take all the shows and try
That's
to get
That's pretty much
shows?
What we've been doing.
Oh, yeah.
That's what we've been doing.
Is it really?
We've been trying to tape as many of these freaking shows as I possibly can get in here.
This guy that
Leap and Larry the Ninja.
Can he come out here for a second?
If he wants to.
Can he come out here for
a second? Just for Larry's sort of camera shy.
Well, the reason I asked for Larry is because he reminds me of a guy that I was in fourth grade with. His name was Edgar.
Edgar.
Oh no.
No, he got just like it.
Larry's the man. Larry friggin' is at every puts these shows together. He's got probably I think last year his total for shows, because he puts each individual band on
as an individual show.
I think he had like 280 shows or something.
Come on, they ought to give you a Grammy award. Let me go scratch your name in it and polish it up. Put it around, you know, da da da.
That's
and
right.
The award goes to Larry.
That's right. Larry gets the job done, man. And he just loves music.
That is great. So Larry, let me ask you something. How does it feel to be behind the scenes when you're back there like that? I mean, what are some of the tricks and things that you do back there other than just let the camera roll?
Different world.
No, but I mean,
you
get a chance to see it before it actually, you know, I mean, the camera's quick. It's quick. It's now. It's there.
Okay.
But you're actually behind the camera. So your ear is kind of oversight what's being recorded or taken.
Oh, yeah.
So do you ever, like, feel like sometimes that you want to, like, take your camera and just go, oh, I see something going over in the car, and move it back? Do you ever feel that?
If they're hearing it, everybody hears the suit.
Yeah.
Well, people hear the suit.
Well, see, this is the thing. There's been crowds where there's five people.
Really?
And then there's crowds where there's 100 people.
Right.
And Larry makes them all look like.
Yeah, he does. I was counting how many times I saw me in the last year. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4. And it wasn't me. But no, in reality, I think you've got a great show.
And we go all over the place. We do what we do is we film the show.
Yeah.
We film the bands. We film the interviews. And then me and Chris will go out
to
all these various locations.
Yeah.
And we'll film.
Who pays for all that gas? You pay for all your own pot?
Yeah.
Do you?
It's all volunteer. I fork out everything. I work out.
Can I get just a little political?
Go ahead, brother. Jump
in. So you actually pay for this out of your own pocket?
Yeah. A good majority of this.
So is there any write-offs involved?
Not really.
None? There's not even a kickback or anything. You just have to come straight out of your pocket.
Pretty much. Yeah. It's all for the love of the art, brother.
That's good. That's good. That's really good. But, you know,
I've been wanting to do this show since 93. And then when I moved here, bam.
You know,
TV show.
When, do you remember?
Oh, back in the day.
Do you remember?
We had several good conversations.
When you sent me the, and I thought, man, this is, you know, I went through the site, and I went through even your extension of some of the other people you were working with. I was like, wow, this dude is, you know, this is better than Jack Benny in 1955. Or that's Jack Barr. But I mean, you know,
it was.
I saw that and I thought, well, and then I heard you came in. And I didn't know that until probably the last 6 months or so.
Yeah.
I really didn't. I knew you were in the area.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so I think it's great. I really do. I'm impressed, number one, because it's about time for change. It's time for change. It's about time for change.
It's not just a political slogan.
Yeah, that's true. It's a necessity. But, you know, I think it's good. I think it's time for change. I think your show should probably, if you're going to build it, I think you should be in the top rating. You know what I mean?
Well, see, what's funny is we bill ourselves as the lowest rated show on Access.
Yeah, I heard.
However, there ain't a soul in this town that hasn't seen that.
That's true. And that's what I love about it. I love the idea that it, because it grabbed me. I won't get
it. And then we put everything on, and we put things on the internet, and people that don't get the channel, we go see them.
Yeah, clips on there too?
We bring the internet audience from the radio show in.
Cool. That's what we were going to do.
Okay.
You know, so how about I just give you a CD of the show and let you just rap?
Whatever you want to do, bro. Whatever you want to do, my man.
That'll work. I just don't have the video to go along with it, so I have to sit side sound and you go, oh yeah, this is the song I played for them. They emailed me from Hawaii.
That's right. But yeah, man, thanks for doing this. I think
the show's great. I wouldn't have missed it for the world. I think change is important. And I think your show has a twist to it. I like the twist.
They gave us awards. We won some access awards.
Did you really?
Not the right ones.
I got not the right ones, but we won some.
Was there any freedom involved in this?
Not really.
Not much. That's what I was looking for.
That's right.
No. No, but I think it's good. You know, I'm really proud of you. I think
well,
you're doing a real job.
Appreciate it, man.
I think what I've seen in the show, you know, and it's the sky's the limit.
Oh, yeah.
And in this day and age, with all that goes on in this world, I think it's, like I said earlier, I think it's time for some change. And I think you've got the key to what's been missing. You know, it looks thin now, you know.
Oh, yeah.
But there's enough light to get through it. And I think that if you keep just rolling with whatever, you know what I'm saying? I think you'd be great.
We're chugging away, man.
I think it's a great show.
I remember with the internet show, I was interviewing unsigned bands and freaking transsexual porn stars, and now I'm interviewing Ed McMahon and people like that.
Did you say transsexuals?
Oh, yes.
Hey, Cliff, you had your wife on you.
And we were interviewing Gia Darling, the most downloaded transsexual porn star on the internet.
Yeah.
We're interviewing all these people. Now all of a sudden, I'm getting best-selling authors, Ed McMahon, all these people. I'm like, how the hell am I getting these people?
You know,
and it's
when,
just,
it's, when it's good, it's good.
Well, see, this is the thing.
Everybody wants a part of what's good. They want to be a part of it. I'm here.
I'll tell you, brother.
And I don't know.
And we've been waiting a while to get you on.
Well, we have. Yeah. And I'll return your favor. I will. But I know that out of all the places that I've been, Sewanee, Kansas, and I'm originally from Hastings, Nebraska. You know, we're good for some what we're good for. I got the, what is it? The team, the red.
Cornhuskers.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to get. They got something going on there. But I think Sewanee has a vaster opportunity for success.
Okay.
I think it's time to go.
The ice machine, brother. Chiming in to say hi.
We should
credit them at the end of the show. Ice Machine played by the way.
What is that, Manitou? Oh, no, that's
it's got ice.
That's a cool way to look at it. Works, right? But no, I think it's going to do well. And I'm looking forward to watching the show.
Oh,
so, not just our show. You can take our show and do what you want. You can get in the editing room and look at it. Nah, I'll freeze on it.
What's great about it is that we film all these bands,
yeah,
and then I put one show together a week, and we've got.
I know you're back on
all these freaking bands, and we're putting them together as fast as we can. We're getting them on the air. It was originally one show a month.
Yeah.
I was going to do one show a month, not a big deal. And then it was, I had two shows a month. And then it became, going on every week. And now it's, if I can crank out two a week, I'm happy.
So, and that's good.
Oh, yeah.
Have you ever thought about spending some time and like trying to find which bands do the same songs and then taking half of a song? You know where I'm going.
Oh, yeah.
You know where I'm going. You know what I mean? You know, I just kind of, that's a little editing involved in it.
Oh,
can you see that? You know, like, you know how they do the commercials with the